Hello, this is Kayla Mace with Phoenix Contact USA. Today, we will go over how to connect your AXCF2152 to Microsoft Azure. Before we begin, there are a few requirements we should double check. You will need an AXCF2152 controller. Your controller will need firmware version 2019.9 or newer. You will also need one of the two SD card options for expansion. PLC Next Engineer 2019.9 should be installed, as well as PuTTY and WinSCP. You will need an Azure Portal account enabled. This can be a free trial version or any other account with a payment option you may have. Also, your AXCF2152 must be connected to the internet. So how does it all work? We start with the PLC Next engineering library that was created to act as an HTTP client and take the data from the PLC Next engineer into the AXCF2152. The data can then be passed into the operating system of Linux. Once in the Linux system, we can run an Azure SDK node that grabs that same data and takes it to the Azure cloud. Continuing with getting connected to Azure, we first need to go to GitHub. You can find all the files on the repository at PLC Next AWS Azure. Go ahead and download the files that you need. Then extract the newly downloaded files. Make sure to remember the location of these files. We will be using the Azure AWS setup script. Go ahead and open WinSCP and connect to your controller using the SFTP connection. If you haven't logged into your controller previously and need more information, check out the quick start guide on our website. Find the Azure AWS setup script from earlier and drag and drop that into the controller. Execute a PuTTY session. You can do this from WinSCP. Go ahead and log in with your same credentials. After you're logged in, switch to a root user. Make sure that the file is still there. Now, we will need to change the file to be an executable. So execute chmode. Once that is done, you can execute the file by bashing it. The script will install and do everything that needs to be done on the Linux side. It will create all the files and directories. You can leave that running, it will take a few minutes. After that's done, we'll visit our Azure account. Log into your portal. Most everything for Azure works by searching under All Resources, so we will use that search bar a lot. Go ahead and click on Resource Groups. You will need to add a new resource. You can use a free trial or the account that you want charged. We are going to call our group PLC Next. Go ahead and create it. Now on the resource group, we will go back and search for the IoT hub and we add a device to the IoT hub using that same resource group. Give it a name. Create it. Go to Resources, IoT devices, and create a new IoT device. That's going to be a storage type device where the data will be saved. We'll call it AXCF2152. You can leave everything as it is, as those keys and everything will be auto-generated later.
Now save.
Here's an important step. Find the primary connection string. Copy that and save it for later. You can use a Word document to temporarily store the string. Now let's go back to the IoT hub.
Inside the PLC Next Test Day resource, we are going to create a route to add a message routing.
Give it a name. We are going to call it PLC Next Test Day. The endpoint will be a blob storage. We will call it PLC Next Blob Storage. Let's pick a container. We don't have one, so we'll create it. We will give it a name. Click on the container. Add a container and give it a name. You can leave it as private. Click OK. Go into that private container. Let's get the sliders all the way back and click Create. Now that it's complete, we will use PLC Next Engineer to add the connection string. Open PLC Next Engineer. Make sure you have the controller set up and ready for deployment. Add a new library. You can use the library you downloaded from the GitHub. Click File, Import from another project, and use the file from GitHub. This has the Azure example. Accept all the files. Click Yes. Under Programming, Local, Programs, and Main, you should have your pre-compiled code ready to go. We will be checking and changing a few variables. The first one is the key.
We can now copy and paste the connection string into our variables and then go to the initial. Make sure that there's a single quote at the beginning and at the end of the string so that's formatted correctly.
Also, double check your IP address. Make sure that it's the same as your controller. All right, we're ready to deploy. Go ahead and deploy your code. Once everything is ready and running, you can debug. You'll notice that not all the blocks are active, and we still need to execute a reboot on the Linux to make sure that the PLC Next and Azure SDK are synchronized. Go ahead and execute a reboot via Linux kernel, PLC Next, or PowerCycle your device. Once it's back online, you can debug again. You'll see that all the blocks are active this time, especially the client. Once that is done, with no diagnostic errors, you can go back to the Azure portal and go to Storage Account. PLC Next. And under your containers, you will see that some data is getting there. The data will take at least 60 seconds to get there. It is collecting data every 1 second from the example code. Every 60 data reading operations in the file, you can download and compare the data. To open the file, use WordPad or anything else that can read it. You should see the data that is being saved is the same as the blocks are sending in the program. Thanks for watching this video. If you have any questions, please reach out to us at PLC Next Community. Stay tuned for more contributions in all things around cloud and IIoT.